The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
In Fairfield County, something new comes across my desk every day. Crimes are committed, cases are solved, and a community is made safe by the hardworking employees of the Fairfield County Sheriff's Office.
Welcome to This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan, a weekly program here on LSN Television. We're also carried by a number of the radio affiliates here in Lancaster. Do appreciate you, the viewers and listeners that join us each and every week. The nice calls and cards we get about this program is very much appreciated. This program is actually produced at Fairfield Christian Academy. The students put this together, and it's really appreciated because without them, we wouldn't have this program. Our executive producer, Kelly Roberts, who takes care of lining the guests up, getting a lot of research on the questions, and does a good job. Back by popular demand, second week in a row.
Thank you, sir.
Chief Dave Ward,
yes.
The chief of the Lancaster Fire Department. Glad to have you back.
Thank you for having me. It's been a lot of fun.
So Christmas coming up. Have you got all your presents and everything?
No, we're just getting into the getting into it. So.
Okay.
We've been blessed. You know, you think about Christmas and you see all the advertisements and you know, it's much more than the gifts. It's about Jesus Christ. And so we don't get too carried away with buying the gifts. We do buy a few, but we enjoy the family and the church services and things.
Yeah, that's what it's about. Many times I think we get in the presents and the lights and the thing, and we forget that, the reason we celebrate is the birth of Christ.
Exactly.
And so sometimes that's forgotten or so marginalized today or with the materialism of Christmas, but it's good to be reminded of that.
Exactly.
Yeah. We've got just a lot of things to talk about, and so let's start. We're going to talk a little bit about home heating.
Yes, let's talk about that.
And some of the things, some of the problems that you see in the fire service and things people need to know.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about furnaces first.
Okay.
The time to think about your furnace is probably not when it turns down to 8 degrees like it did a month or two ago, but it's a good time to think about it in October. But you want to have a qualified service technician come out, check your if you have a standing pilot, check your pilots and make sure that everything's working, clean out the chamber. So there's a lot of things to think about.
Only in television.
So, yes.
Okay.
So get your furnace checked by a reputable service technician.
Okay. So that's the one thing. How often should you do that?
I do mine annually. I have a trusted service technician. He comes out sometime around either October or November, checks our furnace out, and we know that it's good to go. And then we have no worries about whether it's going to fail when it turns down to 0 degrees or not.
Yeah, I one of the things you hear sometimes is with the furnaces, especially the older ones, sometimes the vent.
Yes.
The vent gets blocked, and
right.
It can be deadly.
Oh, yeah, carbon monoxide can kill quickly.
Yeah.
So with having said that, we always suggest that people have carbon monoxide detectors in their home.
Okay.
And those do have a lifetime, just a serviceable life. And it doesn't last forever. So every 7 or 8 years, you need to go out and buy yourself a new carbon monoxide detector. We get a lot of calls where they say that the carbon monoxide detector's chirping.
Okay.
Well, there's a couple reasons it can be chirping, battery, or it could be carbon monoxide. And don't ever think that you don't want to call us because it's probably the battery. Call us. We'll come out and check it. But it's always a good practice to change your smoke detectors and your carbon monoxide detectors every 5 to 7 years.
Yeah, that's a good point.
It
because
is.
I don't think most people do that.
No, I would say from our past history, yes.
Now, right. with the cold weather right around the corner coming up, and we have power outages.
Oh, yes.
What about these portable generators that people use to
yes.
Keep their home going?
That's a combustion engine, and they produce carbon monoxide. And so if you have your house wired so that you can use a generator, it needs to be away from your house. It doesn't need to be sitting in your garage running. You want to make sure it's far enough out of your area so it doesn't backfeed into the fumes don't backfeed into your house. And there's a lot of things with generators, which could be another whole show.
Yeah.
But just from the carbon monoxide and the safety factor.
You don't even want it too close to a window, do you?
No, not at all.
Okay.
At my house, we have a standalone generator that fires up, it runs off propane, it comes on. If there's a power failure, a transfer switch kicks on within 5 seconds.
Okay.
And that's the best.
Right. What about automobiles? Like sometimes you'll see people, they warm their car up, maybe it's in the garage.
No. If you're going to start your car, start it up, back it out, you know, shut your garage door down, and then you're okay. But you can really fill up a house full of carbon monoxide quickly with a car.
There was a situation a few years ago, and it involved a Columbus police officer and his son. They had actually come home in the evening, put their car in the garage, and they were in a hurry, and they were getting some packages and stuff out. And they inadvertently didn't turn the car off.
And you, it just made me think of something.
They both perished. It's just tragic.
You know, with these cars running so quietly now, and with the remote starts, wouldn't it be easy to push the wrong button? Because you can be, you know, 100 feet or so away, or even longer. Hit that wrong button, not think anything about it, don't hear it. And without a carbon monoxide detector, you may not even know it's out there in your garage running.
Right.
So that's a good thing.
Those are just so important. Yeah. And, you know, tragedy is always just around the corner, so we've really got to be diligent on these on these type of things.
Common sense.
Now, what about certainly space heaters are popular?
Space heaters, the ones you plug in. They all should have, the new ones have tip-over protection, which means that if for some reason it fell over, it wouldn't continue to run.
Okay.
If it doesn't have that, discard it now.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. So you try it out.
Are these electric?
Electric ones, yes, we're talking about. Discard it, get rid of it, go buy yourself a new one. They're relatively inexpensive.
Now, what about the portable ones that run off a fuel base?
Like the kerosene, you want to make sure it's 3 feet away, nothing to catch fire. But you also want to be careful with that. You want to make sure it's vented properly. And if your house is new and they're pretty tight, be very, very cautious. I would recommend not using those kind of heaters.
And certainly the other thing is we get around Christmas time. I've seen people with fireplaces, whether it's a gas fireplace or wood, they'll actually sometimes throw some of the wrapping paper and burn it there.
Yeah, and if we could talk a little bit about that,
good point.
Creosote, you know, chimneys. Before you even light the fire for the first time in every year, you want to make sure either you, and my mother has a wood stove, she loves that warm heat, but I get up and I check to make sure there's no creosote buildup. And you can do that by taking a flashlight, climbing the roof and checking, make sure there's no more than a quarter inch of creosote. Now, if you've never heard of a chimney fire, it sounds like a plane inside your chimney as that fire is consuming that creosote. And if it's not a well-laid fireplace or that's been cracked where it can get through the flue and then the block, it can extend to your house. Or if it's the triple wall, you know, it's going to get cherry red and hopefully there's no radiant heat that catches anything on fire.
So you see some of these now and then?
Oh, yes. Yes. Really? We'll have one or two chimney fires a year. And what happens is they don't clean their chimney. They don't have a qualified chimney sweep come in. They get a fire that's too hot. Or, and then it catches a creosote. Or they damper down their stove, their wood stove or their fireplace, and it just is smoldering fire. And that gets a chance for that to just kind of build up in your chimney. And then when they get that paper, you know, they throw that paper in there, it hits that creosote, catches fire, and you're off to the races. So you want to make sure you clean that chimney every year.
Boy, those are some just great things. The other thing we talked about before airtime was another source of fire is the dryer vents.
Yes, lint. And probably we've all seen how quickly lint can catch fire. And my house is a smaller utility room where it has a washer dryer and a little area there. And that lint can build up underneath your dryer. It can build up inside your vent. And if the motor overheats on the dryer and it catches that lint fire, it really can go fast. So do not have your dryer going and go to bed. Don't have your dryer going and go off to the grocery store or whatever. If you're going to go to bed or go outside, shut your dryer off.
Well, that's important because I tell you, certainly there's been times when we've had the dryer running and we've gone to the store or something and I didn't think too much about it.
And you know, in a fire inspection scenario, we go out to some of the large apartment complexes that have a central dryer and washer dryer, and we ask to see their logs of how often they clean their dryer vents.
Oh, that's,
because it can really be devastating.
Okay. Now, the other thing that, you know, we think about the fire department and putting out fires and those kind of things, but a big part of your responsibility is the medical emergencies.
Yes. That's truly, when you look at most departments across the country. That's anywhere between 85 and 90% of our run volume now.
Okay.
It's been, and I think it's due, Sheriff, from a good building code. So there are far fewer fires now due to the building. We have code inspectors, we have building inspectors. So as these structures are being built, we're out there making sure that they comply with the latest and the best codes.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's EMS. And okay. Truly, it's last year we ran about 6,700 medic runs just in the city limits.
Wow. And you also go outside, right?
Yes.
It's mutual aid?
We have mutual aids. We have automatic responses with the other departments. And so it's the lion's share of our business.
So what's one of the more common causes of medical emergencies? Is it just so big?
You know, it could be heart. It could be falls. You know, as we age, it's a lot of times it's falls. This time of year, you know, when we get heavy snows, and people are out there, and they may be middle-aged or just past middle-aged, and they still, in my mind, I think, you know, I can get out there and do what I did when I was 20.
Oh, yeah.
And you get out there, you start shoveling, and we see a lot of chest pains. Okay. When we have those snows, we see a lot of slips and falls and ice. So you got to be careful with this time of year.
Wouldn't you think when you look at a city like Lancaster? By the way, I'll just compliment you and the folks. You guys really have a good standing in the community and have a reputation of doing a good job. But I live in the city, but having lived out in the country, the idea that you guys will be there mm-hmm. in just a couple minutes,
yes.
As opposed to if you're out in the country, maybe even where a volunteer has to come in mm-hmm. and get the ambulance and go in, probably the chances of survival in a life-threatening situation, yes. you're a lot better in a lot better position if you're in the city, right?
Exactly. And to give you some statistics, the hospital started the STEMI program, which is a heart attack. And in the time we make it to a person's door, to the time we make them to the hospital and they have their artery open through a ballooning, we've had it as few as 30 minutes. From the time we showed up
wow.
to the time they are open is 30 minutes. And in a rural scenario, it might be 15 or 20 minutes before somebody gets there.
Right.
So there are real benefits. And our firefighters and our paramedics, we all are firefighters and we also have paramedics as well, but they do a fantastic job. And that's the key to survival is early recognition and getting that definitive medical treatment like Fairfield Medical Center provides here in our county.
So we're really in Lancaster positioned pretty well.
Yes.
As far as our the police needs with the Lancaster Police Department, the Sheriff's Office, and certainly with the medical needs mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. through the fire department.
Yes. Anywhere in the city, we can be there within 2 to 4 minutes.
Boy, that's terrific.
It is very good.
Now, again, as people hear the sirens coming, mm-hmm. they need to get over.
Yes.
And I think people are pretty compliant with that, but sometimes people aren't paying a lot of attention.
Exactly. Now, our medics are getting louder. We have a lot of air horns. We have better lighting so they can see us farther off. Years ago, you know, you would be up on a driver before they realized you were there.
Right.
So, but we drive with due diligence. You know, they're allowed to go faster than the speed limit, but you know, they have to use due diligence.
Be cautious. Chief, we're just about out of time. Do appreciate you joining us. We'd like to have you back.
Love to be back.
And you've done a terrific job the last couple shows. I've learned a lot, and I'm sure the viewers and listeners uh-huh. would agree that the fire service in Lancaster is going great guns. You guys do a great job, and I'm appreciative of not only your service, but all the firefighters
yes.
in this city.
They do a great job. Yeah. Thank you for having us.
God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And the clock on the wall says we're just about out of time. Been a terrific couple shows with Chief Ward, and appreciate you, the viewers and listeners that join us each and every week, and certainly the students here at Fairfield Christian Academy that make this show possible. I want you to have just a great Merry Christmas. Remember the reason for the season, the birth of Christ. We'll see you right here next week. God bless. If you're out there driving, buckle up. We'll see you here next week.
Waters were woven into the culture of Native American tribes. The descendants of the early Europeans built a business here based on agriculture. And today, this unique destination in the Central Ohio countryside comes to life with stories and memories centuries old. The Fairfield County Historical Parks invites you to amazing Rock Mill. Above the falls of the Hocking River Gorge, here, together, nature and man have created some truly American stories that you'll want to experience with the entire family. Visit us or learn more about Rock Mill and the largest wooden water wheel in the nation at historicalparks.org.